all right, everyone, we're rating this on a quality scale unless something is really fucking fun, because fun will always be better than meta. The meta is only the meta because it's fun.
Obama, that made no fucking sense. Do you understand what you just said? The meta is the meta, not because it's fun, but because it's the most optimal way of playing, even if it's boring.
No, the reason why people play meta is because they find it fun.
Not at all.
You're not going to play a game if it's not fun. It's as simple as that. A bad meta means you don't play. And move to a different game when you can't play a fun way around it.
Okay, I'll give you credit for that one.
Finally, thank you. Now, first off, partisans doctrine. We're doing Soviets first just because...
Absolute dog shit.
SS tier.
What? No way, bro.
Shit is so fucking fun. I don't care that it's trash, it's fun, like you said, Obama.
But partisans are unusable.
Yeah, they do suck, like really bad.
No, they don't. You just have to ambush with them.
Unless you get that nade off and kill like two models or almost kill them. They can't even beat a lead infant point blank with SMGs.
Stun trap?
Nope, not enough. Vet 3 frontline will crush them still.
You're not using them right. Are you getting the ambush bonus or right-clicking on an enemy unit?
They don't get the ambush bonus when you right-click.
I don't think anything does. You have to press S to take them off hold fire.
And let them auto-target.
Oh.
Yeah, it's fucking stupid. But the map hacks and caddy is great.
You have to get too lucky on the barrage. So a lot of times people with just dodge out of it and only lose maybe a couple models.
The vet 1 ability, though.
It's pinpoint accurate. You can wipe emplacement crews with it or just straight up kill it with enough barrages. An almost guaranteed wipe on team weapons.
Yeah, it's pretty bullshit, not gonna lie.
Yes, it is, but too bad it's fun.
Against Wehrmacht, it's utter bullshit. The crews are fragile enough with 4-man.
That sounds like a skill issue.
Because it is.
There is absolutely no counterplay to it whatsoever. No warning until it's too late, and your MG or pack could get decrewed and cost you the whole side of the map.
Whatever put it in S tier.
Now, that's not enough to make it S tier. There's nothing else good besides the tank targeting thing.
Joe, that is really good.
Also, radio intercept so I know what units my opponent's bitch ass is building.
Good for countering and even for counter sniping.
No, I just leave the game if my opponent builds a sniper early on.
I thought you liked them.
Using them, not when I have to deal with that bullshit.
Put it F tier Barak.
No way. The Katusha combo is too good.
Fine, D tier.
No way. Remember when you were complaining about the pinpoint accuracy wiping team weapons?
Fine C tier, but no way the Katusha combo is strong enough and fun enough to be higher.
I like partisans, though.
They're dog shit Trump. They're not even a so bad it's fun when you win kind of thing.
Stun trap and nade easy engagement win.
Ah, yes. Let me use a bunch of munitions to win one engagement.
A bunch of munitions? It costs like 10. And the grenade is just a regular amount, like 35 or something. It's 45 munitions to win an engagement. Are you telling me you wouldn't spend, what, like, hold on, how much do rifle grenades cost again? Let me check.
They cost 30, Donald.
What horseshit? Shit is way too cheap.
For real, USF grenades cost the same amount.
What?
All USF abilities should have their muni cost cut in half.
No way the ability spam is already bad enough.
Fucking bullshit. Way too OP.
No, they're not, Donald.
Yeah, they are.
No, they are.
Gentlemen, let's get back to the doctrines, please.
What part of the doctrine were we on again?
The 45 munitions cost to win an engagement, Donald.
Oh, right. They can also lay mines. And it's a safe engagement, too. It's almost a guaranteed win, even against elite NF.
The mine laying is pretty good.
Vet 5 Obers will still beat them.
Those are Vet 5 Obers. They can beat everything.
Not paratroopers.
What?
The doctrine guys, please.
C tier. Too much extra micro for a reward that isn't worth it.
You have never faced someone using partisans the right way then. We can make a point an absolute bitch to cap or even just decap.
C tier, it's final.
Yeah, I agree with Barak.
Fine then, Joe. Next match, I'll go partisans and show you how good they are.
Okay, next up, guard motor.
Meta.
Absolute S tier.
Yep, the 120 mortar is so dumb and the guards are OP as hell.
The guards are not OP.
What?
No way, bro.
They're not. They even the playing field.
What?
My God.
The Soviets have a terrible front line. They need the elite inf in order to actually beat frontline infantry in the mid game. They have nothing else otherwise.
T-70.
Nah, it ain't that good.
It really isn't with teller mines or just mines in general. Make diving with it way too risky since you're banking so much on your T-70 to help you get through the mid game. Losing that thing during it is hell. Absolute hell. Your cons can't beat any frontline inf at this point since the Axis get their upgrades.
Cons can't even beat frontline inf in the early game.
get a Maxim and merge cons into it and make your opponent cry, get the engineer flamethrower, and it becomes so fucking difficult to not die and just hemorrhage manpower because of the stupid merge ability.
Obama, that's a wild take.
What? That's all they have. Cons early on can only merge or lose battles. That's a, even in the mid game, they can merge and lose battles. That's it.
Ura into Molotov.
Nope, nope.
The anti-tank grenade is also really good with the sprint.
But you don't get that until you get at least the T-70. You don't want to waste the fuel or munitions. Just build mines instead. There's a reason why everyone does that.
They are too extra. An MG and NG flamer with a T-70 or hell, even an AA half-track is already so hard to crack. But then you have the stupid OP guards that can beat your long-range frontline inf. If cons get in close range, your MG sucks dick.
No, it doesn't, Obama.
And firing position, it's so dumb, it's just a screw you. You can't beat me now, Omal.
Nope, no, no, you're wrong. Rifle grenade.
Seriously, even P-grens struggle against them when they get shot while closing the distance.
P-grens? Fucking P-grens. Conscripts get absolutely dominated by them. There is no contest. An unvetted P-gren can give vet 3 conscripts a run for their money, unless they are in green cover and don't have the 7-man upgrade and are shot on approach. Then the cons might win.
I've seen P-grens fight cons. It's pretty bad.
The T-70 and Maxim will deal with them. Honestly, if you don't know that, Trump, then I'm sorry, but you're just a noob. That's how it is.
T-70?
Shrek's Obama.
Thank you, Biden. Shrek's an AT gun. We'll keep that T-70 in its place. You have no clue how hard the Soviets have to work their ass off to hold back the Axis player.
Donald, that's just true vice versa. Is the opponent is good, this game makes you work your ass off. Doubly so if you're allies. As for guards, they are amazing, can help the Soviets in the mid-game, where P-grens or Obers will dominate cons.
Exactly. Thank you, Biden.
And Obama, if you're struggling against firing position, then like Trump said, a rifle grenade is very good
preach,
against
brother,
them
preach.
Since they are so static. Now, we don't need to talk about the 120. It's great and has no downsides besides arguably a lack of a flare, but has timed explosives that are good against, well, just about everything, I think.
No, it's pretty dog shit against infantry.
Really?
Yeah, it just does no damage for some reason. Kind of stupid, but whatever. Not going to hit them anyway with that timer.
Oh, well, okay then. The T-34-85 seems good, but I don't see it much. I don't play Soviet, so I don't really know.
The main gun is really powerful.
It's trash, Obama. It can barely beat out a Panzer IV. And it costs 45 more fuel, 5 more than an SU-85. Why would I ever go for it when I can use that fuel for an SU-85 or get another T-34? It needs a main gun buff, or the MGs on it need a huge buff if it's going to be worth the 35 extra fuel.
Well, there you go. Next up, the crew repair. Being able to repair your tanks without engineers is always a plus.
Yeah, but if it's in combat, you can't cancel it.
So?
You're locked into repairs while you're being shot. You can't fight back.
Bruh.
Yeah, it's fucking dumb.
Okay, next up, Mark vehicle.
No need to talk about it. It's good.
Okay, gentlemen, it's settled. Meta.
No shit, Barry. Why did we even talk about this one?
We still need to talk about the meta when we're making a tier list with it in it.
Fine.